In this tutorial, you'll learn how to remove the background from any video using DaVinci Resolve Studio, allowing you to create your own special effects movies or make some great memes by adding people into different scenes. Once you've opened DaVinci Resolve with the video you want to edit, head over to the DaVinci Resolve Color module. In the Color module, open the Magic Mask menu by clicking on this icon here. In this menu, you can select just the person from the video and remove the original background. First, make sure the selector icon with the plus symbol is activated, so you can select the person. Also, turn on the toggle mask overlay option. With this option activated, the selection from the magic mask will be highlighted in red, allowing you to see and check that it's correct. Perfect! Finally, in the quality settings, I recommend changing from faster mode to better mode, as this will make the mask selection of the person or object much more precise. Great! Now that everything is set up, it's time to start selecting the person in the video. It's advisable to find a frame in the video where the person is clearly visible. Let's try to find a moment in the video where the man's shoes are also visible. Right. In this part here, you can see the entire leg, which will help us make a complete selection of the person using Magic Mask. To start selecting the person with Magic Mask, simply place the cursor over the viewer, click the left mouse button, and hold. Now we begin to trace around the entire person with this blue line. Try to be as precise as possible. The more precise the selection, the easier it will be for Magic Mask to identify and select the person correctly. And done. In just a few seconds, we've achieved an almost perfect mask of the person. We just need to fix a small detail. If we zoom in on the video and look closely, we can see that Magic Mask has selected part of the background in the gaps between the arms. This can be easily corrected. It's as easy as selecting the selector icon with a minus symbol. And with this selector, we can remove the unwanted areas and carefully select the gaps next to the arm. Awesome. Now we have a perfect mask of the entire person. To wrap up, we just need to perform motion tracking so that the magic mask follows the person's movement throughout the video. To perform the tracking, simply click on the icon with the two arrows. Once clicked, the mask will automatically follow the person. Done! We're finished, and we can now deactivate the toggle mask overlay option so that the person no longer appears highlighted in red. The next step is to remove the background from the video, and it couldn't be easier. First, right-click on the node panel and select the Add Alpha Output option. Upon clicking, a blue circle will appear on the right side of the panel. This circle represents the alpha output, which will allow us to have the video without any background. Next, we need to connect the node where we created the magic mask to the alpha output. Simply click on this small blue square on the node and connect it with the blue circle. And as you can see, the video no longer has a background. Finally, if you want to slightly improve the edge of the selection so it's less noticeable that we've cut the person from the video, I recommend adjusting the radius setting. Slightly increasing this value, setting it at 1, is usually sufficient. With this change, the edges of the selection will be much smoother. We can clearly see this on the area around the head. We no longer have that small, bright edge that we had before. Okay, now that we have a video of just the person, how can we add any background we want to the video? It's very easy. We need to go back to the Edit module of DaVinci Resolve. Now, place the video of the person on an upper video track. Having it on video track 2 is fine. Then, simply place the video you want to use as a background on the lower track. It's straightforward. Important! I know many of you will encounter this issue, so I want to mention it. If you make changes to the video clip where we applied the magic mask from the edit module, such as adjusting the zoom, you'll notice that the mask disappears. It's not exactly that the mask disappears, but rather that when you make changes, the motion tracking is removed, and we must perform it again. If you prefer to avoid this issue, I recommend watching this other video where I show you how to export the video without a background. This way, you can make all the changes you need. Another solution is to create the magic mask directly in Fusion. However, in my experience, magic mask tends to work much slower in Fusion.